Ideas are like rabbits. You get a couple of them and know how to handle them, and soon enough, you have a dozen. John Steinbeck. Ideas are the catalyst for change. They allow us, from that little spark in our mind, to say, what can we create out of these ideas? And you could have a bunch of them, as John was explaining in the quote, but how do you present them in a way that people get excited about your ideas? Where people say, wow, I want to get involved. I'm inspired. What can I do to support your mission and your dreams? And that's the focus of today's conversation. Hi, everyone. Brendan here from Master Talk, on your go-to channel to mastering your talk. And today we're covering the art of how to present your ideas with ease. So let's get into it. Number one, get inspiration from other individuals who have worked on similar ideas. That's it. It's a simple principle, but I'm shocked at how many innovators don't think about this. We focus so much on the future that we forget about the past. And you know what the best way to pitch your idea is? The best way is to talk about the past and explain why the past isn't sufficient enough for today's world. So whenever an innovator comes up to me and says, well, Brenda, I need help with my pitch. How do I communicate my ideas, my company, my organization, my ideas to the world? And I always go, well, have you looked at what other competitors have done in your space and how they pitch their ideas? And they always say no. I'll give you a great example of this. Reed Hastings, who's the CEO of Netflix, as we all know, we all watch Netflix on a day-to-day basis almost. When he first pitched the idea of Netflix, that was initially a DVD service, a red box, that was sent to consumers across the world, primarily in the United States, to rent DVDs without having going to a store, instead of explaining just the solution, he used the past to explain the present, like so. Well, Blockbuster, if you're still using that, you're spending hours on end waiting in line. The best movies are already rented out, and you just wasted 2 to 3 hours of your life trying to find a movie to enjoy with your family. But with Netflix, you don't have to waste a second. We'll send the DVDs straight to you, and if you don't like the service, or if you spend too much time going through it, we won't even charge you late fees. That's how Reed explained Netflix. He used the past to explain the present. Same thing with Steve Jobs. He didn't just talk about the iPhone. He talked about how the iPhone was different than BlackBerry. Are you still using physical keyboards on your phone? Well, my friends, that is the past. Because with the iPhone, you don't need a physical keyboard. You can just type anything you need to directly on a screen, and the crowd goes wild. And that's the key, everyone. Use the past to explain your ideas today. Use the past to talk about why those ideas don't work anymore and why your solution, what you care about, is what people should be paying attention to. Number two, have dinner conversations with the people that you seek to serve. So you've spent 2 to 3 hours analyzing your competitors, watching their pitch, really understanding how they pitch their solution and who they are. But the journey has just begun, my friends, because the next part to presenting your ideas easily is having dinner, informal conversations with the people you actually want to impact. Once again, a simple principle, but a principle most of us don't implement. How many of us are hanging out with our core customers? How many of us are having those intimate conversations with the people we actually want to help? This is where the magic happens. And during those conversations, ask very specific questions. Questions like, if you were to change one thing about my idea, what would you change and why? If you were to explain my idea back to me, how would you explain it? These are the questions that allow you to gain insights that any spreadsheet or any data or graph can't really do for you. It's those intimate conversations that allows you to get to the next level. Airbnb's founders did that exceptionally well. When they started building the product, they had dinners and conversations with the first 100 to 200 hosts on the platform, probably a lot more, and had those intimate conversations, actually hung out with them. And they were able to get a lot of insights that spreadsheets and reports weren't going to give them. So take that extra mile and meet your audience, have dinner with them, and you'll stand out from everyone else. Number three, make a list of every possible objection to your ideas and crush them up front. Here's the magic of innovation. It allows us to move forward as a society. It allows us to progress and make things better. But there's also a challenge. And the challenge is this: most human beings don't want to change. They want to stay the same. They want to try new things. They want to keep the status quo. So your job as the person who has the idea is to make such a compelling case that people have to see it your way. Think about Google. So many people in the early 2000s, even if it sounds crazy today, might have looked at Google and said, well, why do I need a search engine? I could just go to the library and look up a book. Why do I need to spend time on Google? Same thing with Amazon. Why do I need to shop online? They're going to steal my credit card number. No, no, no. We can't shop online. This is dangerous. So when you think about all of these objections that people used to have anyways, you're able to figure out what they are proactively rather than reactively and find solutions to those ideas. So if you're Google's founder in the early 2000s and you're pitching the service to people, it would sound something like this. Yeah, sure, you could read books in the library, but how long will that take you? You have to drive to the library, pick out the book, spend multiple minutes, maybe even hours, going through the book to find the right information. Or with Google, you can just type a few seconds and click a button and you'll have the answer. And by the way, it's free. What's better? Google. Same thing with Amazon. Okay, here's what we'll do with online shopping. We'll make sure your credit card is protected, and we'll promise free shipping and delivery on anything you want versus you having to drive to a store and look for things that might be sold out. With Amazon, you can just click a button and it'll appear in front of your house without moving. And it'll be cheaper than going to any store because they don't have to pay rent costs. Boom, the customer is convinced. That's the key. Focus on the past, but more importantly, figure out every objection possible to your idea and crush each of them individually. And at some point, your idea will be so good, everyone who needs it the most will be bought into it. As John Steinbeck explains, ideas are like rabbits. The second you figure out the process of developing a few, eventually you'll have a dozen. So what's the key here? The key is if you want to present your ideas easily, always keep your ear on the ground. Always pay attention to the people you want to serve, who your competitors are, how other individuals are pitching your idea. And if you always keep a keen ear on the ground, eventually your idea will be so refined that the world will wait in line to hear it. As always, if you enjoyed this week's episode of Master Talk, be sure to smash that like button and subscribe to the YouTube channel as well to see more videos like this. And if you know one person who's struggling with presenting their ideas, be sure to send them this video so that they'll be one step closer to mastering their talk. See you next time, everyone. Take care.